Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel. This is Rajao from IIT Madras. I am an MS Research Scholar in the Department of Electrical Engineering at IIT Madras. Along with that, I am also pursuing BS in Data Science and Programming from IIT Madras online degree program. And currently, I am in the degree level and I have completed all the requirements for the diploma and the foundation level. So in this video, based on my own experience in this whole journey of IIT MBS degree program, I am going to share my journey of the MAD1 project, which is considered as a very important part of this program. So in this video, I'm going to tell you how I completed all the requirements of this MAD1 project in a very short span of time and how I finally was able to secure an S grade in this project course. So if you are not aware about this MAD1 project, let me clarify in the beginning itself. It stands for the Modern Application Development 1. And it concerns about the web application development, about its front end, back end, and we have to integrate it with the ORM, which in our case is the SQL Alchemy database. And we have to use the various technologies like Flask, Jinja, Bootstrap, Vue.js, Redis, Celery, and all in this MAD1 and MAD2 project. And there are subsequent theory courses associated with it. So if I tell you about my journey, so I took the theory course of the MAD1 in May 2023 term. So at that time, to be honest, I really do not enjoy this theory course because there are a lot of terminologies in this theory course and there are a lot of theory and all are dumped in the single course and there are a lot of memorization part as well. And at many point of time, I was not able to reconnect the dots and not able to grasp some of the concepts well. But when I implemented this functionality during my project in the next term, I was able to understand and appreciate this concept really well. So in my case, at least, this project course worked really great and it also helped me to the build on the MAD2 project in which I also get S grade. So it is very important to understand and devote your time towards completing this project. And I would suggest you please complete it very honestly and seriously, because if you don't complete, you will face its repercussions at the later stage. So in my case, the problem statement was the music streaming app, and I have to design and web app to stream web stream music application. So like many people, including I, faced difficulty in starting this project because there are lot of requirements which you need to implement in this project, MAD1 and MAD2. So many people are afraid to start working on this project, and before starting only they generally give. But that is the not right way to complete this project. So first thing I did, I really tried to understand the requirements carefully and completely. So I went through the project problem statement, which is a PPT. So I went through that PPT a lot of times. I think it is at least 15 times. So I try to understand each and every word of that problem statement so that I would not have to face any problem during my viva. So that should be your first step for completing this project, because if you don't understand this problem statement carefully, you will not implement its core requirement. If you not complete core requirement, you will not be able to pass level 1 is just a checklist which you need to complete. So like that. So for understanding the problem statement, I would suggest you to go through the discourse as well and the live sessions. So some of the live session videos are quite really helpful for this project. So after understanding the project problem statement, so in my case it was a music streaming application, as I've told you. So it has three rows: user, creator, and admin. So any user can become a creator, like in real life, and we have to implement the functionalities for all these roles. So we have to implement the login functionality, which can be separate login or the same login. So during MAT 1 we can use the Flask login, but in MAT 2 we have to use extra security. So that's why they have used to use hashing and the JWT security for the extra security, and how we can implement that. So during MAT 2, which is just an extension of the MAT 1, we have to implement that. And after login, we have to implement the dashboards for all of them. And then we have to implement the CRUD operations for all of them: create, read, update, and delete. And we have to implement the register option. And then along with that, we have to integrate it with the database, which is the SQL Alchemy database in our case. So like that, also we have to design the search functionality as well. And there should be an option to create playlist, edit playlist, delete playlist, and to play the song. So there are a lot of things, and if you don't structure it properly, you will not be able to implement all of them in a limited time. So that is the first thing. And after understanding the problem statement really well, first thing is to decide which IDE you need to use, because in our case there are two IDE which you can use. There is one Replit and there is a Visual Studio Code, which generally most of the students adopt. So I was also really confused which IDE is better, but at the end I decided to go with the Visual Studio, because that is actually really handy and very helpful, because Visual Studio is used for the lot of projects as well. So that will be helpful in my other courses as well. So I decided to go for the VS Code, and I will also suggest to work on the VS Code, because there is no problem the plagiarism in the VS Code, because all the things are local. Otherwise in Replit there can be some problem with the plagiarism. So that is one thing. And after this, I was also really confused how the things for the plagiarism work. So I decided to work on my own. I took some help from the internet and the YouTube, and some of the help from the ChatGPT as well. But I really tried to ensure that all the things would be quite customized to my own, and I understand the logic and try to write my own code based on that logic, so that there would be no problem for the plagiarism in the future. So that you also need to ensure, because if you copy all the codes from any source, there could be some problem on the plagiarism, and which happened in many cases, and in that case that would be not a good thing. So you really need to avoid that. So that is other thing. Apart from that, so in the MAT 1, so believe me, that is very easy project course if you go deep inside it. But if you look from the outer only, it might seem difficult to you. But if you deep dive into it, this is actually a very easy project course. You just need to make HTML templates, and you need to integrate all the templates with each other if you want to complete it. So that is the simplest way to complete this project. And there is no need to implement API. API is recommended but not necessary in this MAT 1. But in MAT 2 you might need to use the API. So even without the API you can easily complete it. So what you have to need to do in this project. So you have to use the Flask for the backend, and you have to use the Jinja for the front end and the CSS part, and the Bootstrap as well for the CSS and front end. And you have to use the SQL Alchemy for the ORM, that is database. So these all three things you have to do, and you have to write in Python. So you have to work one by one. First, try to work on the front end. Like I started with the designing the templates, how the things will be. Like for me, in my case, it was the music streaming and application. So I first decided to build my home page. So without integrating with anything, I first designed a simple HTML template for home page. So I took one static image folder for the music application logo, and then I write the music streaming application, and then created the button for the login and the name and username and password, created button for the register. So I first completed the home page. Similarly, I designed the HTML page for a register. So in the register, there's a name and the password, create password, re-enter password, which music you like that, and there's a button for the register. So similarly, I created the HTML pages for each and every component which I need to create, and then at the end, using Flask as the backend, I integrated all these HTML templates, and then at the end, my application was over. So I know, since I'm speaking and I've completed the project already, it might feel quite trivial to me now, but during at that time it was quite difficult to integrate all this because there are a lot of errors coming, and if you don't understand the program, you might get quite fed up with the error, and at some point of time you feel like how to complete it, because you have to complete it by your own or on your own, and there are not some much help because this is an online program. But there's not like that. You can easily take the help from the instructor, and there's one project mentor also allotted to you. You can take that help, and then in discourse also you can query about your problem. So in this like that, and after completing this project requirement, all the components. So as far as I know, I have not implemented any APIs during at that time because I was really not comfortable with API. But during Med 2, I go through the theory component of the API. So I was able to implement that API part in the Med 2. And so in the Med 2, you have to implement other components as well. So you have to implement the passing, scheduling, and the caching using the salary and Redis, and you have to show your mail export option. You have to use a mail hog also, and you have to use primarily use a Vue.js. So I will make a separate video for the Med 2 project, so how you can complete it properly. So after completing all the requirements, then there was a time for the Viva. So and before Viva, you have to prepare a report also. So that report is not very much difficult to prepare. So if you have completed the project by your own, you can simply write what have you completed. So there is a proper format for that. You can take the format and write about it. So I write about my schema design. So I really kept the schema very quite simple. I do not integrate. I do not make the schema complex. Even if you make the schema quite simple, then it's quite sufficient and good to go. You are not required to make a very complex schema connected by each other using primary key, secondary key, not like that. You can simply make three schemas. Like in my case, I had designed one table for the user, one table for the songs, and one table for the creator, and like that. I was not able to really recall about that, but it was like that only, quite simple and quite steady. So I write about that schema in the report and write about the different templates. So in my case, it was about 15 to 20 templates. So I wrote about that, the different functionalities of that templates, and then different technologies used in the project. After the project report, there was a level 1 Viva and level 2 Viva. So level 1 Viva was quite simple. You just need to demonstrate your project, and you just need to show different components of the project or whatever components which are asked by your proctor, and that is quite simple, and you will really pass this level if you complete it quite honest. So the next tackle comes the level 2, which was quite difficult. If you don't understand the theory component of the project also. So in the level 2 IVA, they generally ask about the theory more about the theory instead of the project. So in my case also, the level 2 IVA was more concentrated about the theory, and there's a little talk about the project code. And in my case, I was also asked to make some modification, like they was to like after writing your name in the register, it should be added in the database as the capital letters. So that was quite trivial and simple. So I was able to do that. So similar small changes you will be asked to do. And if you have done your programming by your own, you will be really able to complete it. But apart from that project, there are a lot of questions from the theory part. So you need to be quite fluent in the theory as well, especially related from the week 1 to week 6. And there are a lot of questions available in the discourse. So please go through the discourse also before appearing for your Viva. So that's the thing, and that's my journey about my MAD1 project. So in the crux, I can give you some advice, like start your project course as early as possible. And second thing is like understand your project first and then start implementing on your project. And third thing is like even if you are not completing your project during your theory, even if you are not taking your project course during your theory, it is better to go through the problem statement once during your theory itself. So when you try to complete the project course in the next term, you might have the fair idea about the project. So that is quite a good strategy to work. So I would suggest you to take your project course in the next term, especially for the MAD1 and MAD2 project. So take the theory course first, and in the next term take the project course, and during your theory course go through the project requirement, try to complete it, try to implement it. And during your actual project course, you might have the good amount of time to actually implement your project. In some case, the problem statement might get changed, but still the basic design is same. So that's about my project course. I would make a similar video about the other MAD2 project or other project course as well. So others might get benefited from it. So that's all. Thank you for watching this video. I will meet you in some another video. Thank you for watching this video. Happy learning. Goodbye. Take care.